All right, so welcome to a delayed tablet 4 of the Epic of Gilgamesh. Tablet 4 is entitled The Journey to the Forest of the Cedar. I just recorded a 12-minute meditation video in preparation for reading this, so if sitting contemplatively in front of a computer screen is something that interests you, you can check out the meditation playlist over there and sit and breathe with me while contemplating Gilgamesh. Or you can just watch this video, which is the video that you're already watching. So this video is an introduction to Tablet 4, so I thought I would summarize Tablets 1 through 3 for you, in case you've forgotten, very briefly. So, in Tablet 1, we hear that Gilgamesh is this really, really great king. Well, actually, first in Tablet 1, we hear, like, hey, let's read this tablet. It's in the lapis lazuli stone, and it's in this great ark, and you should come read this tablet, and it's very, like, ancient tablet, YouTube. Anyway, so on this ancient tablet, you learn that Gilgamesh is the king of Uruk, and he's a really great guy, except that he likes to rape a lot of women. And so the people of the city say, hey, could you stop raping our newly wed brides? And Gilgamesh says no, and so the gods, they create this man Enkidu, who's this wild man, and Enkidu is in the forest, and he's this wild man, and everyone's afraid of him, and then the people send Shamhash to go seduce Enkidu, and she seduces Enkidu, and then brings Enkidu back to the city, where he confronts Gilgamesh and says, stop raping all those women, and Gilgamesh says, okay, after they fight. And then Gilgamesh decides that, you know, since he can't rape his way to immortality, he needs to seek it in another way, and so he decides that with Enkidu, they are going to go to the cedar forest of Humbaba, where they will slay Humbaba and bring back all of the cedars. And all the gods tell Gilgamesh, no, this is a terrible idea, and all of the people in the city say, no, this is a terrible idea, but Gilgamesh says, I'm going to do it anyway, I'm going to bring back the cedars, we're going to have two New Year's festivals in 1 year, it's going to be a big deal, I'm going to be an immortal man, and you're going to hear about me for thousands of years. Seems like he succeeded a little bit. So that's Tablet 3. And Tablet 4, they set off. Alright, so I will read a summary of Tablet 4 to you. Tablet 4, The Journey to the Forest of Cedar. Every 3 days in the course of their journey, Gilgamesh and Enkidu pitch camp on a hillside and conduct a ritual to provoke a dream. Dreaming, like that. Each time Gilgamesh wakes from a nightmare, but Enkidu reassures him that his dream is favorable after all. After at least 5 such dreams, the heroes draw near the forest of the cedar. Shamhash advises a speedy attack in order to catch unawares the ogre Humbaba, who guards the cedar cloaked in his 7 auras. 7 auras, 7 chakras. He's an Eastern Swami, maybe. That's a little anachronistic, but... anyway... Humbaba guards the cedar cloaked in his 7 auras. As the heroes anxiously try to allay each other's fears, they arrive at the forest. So, one thing to think about for this video is Tablet 4 is incredibly repetitive. Like, incredibly repetitive. You'll see what I mean when I start repeating it. But it's not repetitive in like a tedious, like, oh my god, again, they're stopping for another dream ritual again. But it's like, there's this, you can get into this rhythm of it, and you can like feel the scene that they're in because they use the same adverbs and adjectives each time. And there's just like this cycle, cycling, do the same thing and the same thing and the same thing. And that's some aspect of religious ritual that, is often overlooked, the sort of, the strength that comes from the repetition of an action. And you know, all of life is this crazy kind of cycling, you know, death, birth, cell cycle, anaphase, telophase, metaphase, prophase, over and over. Those were out of order, by the way. But life is a cycle, and you know, there's a number of philosophers who would say that's all that life is. There's no material that is living. The only thing that is living is the material process, the cycling, the constant looping over and over and over. I could talk about that forever. I won't. But just be aware that Tablet 4 is very repetitive, And as you're watching, I want you to think about the meaning of repetition, the purpose of repetition, and how repetition adds to this piece. And if you have any interesting thoughts that you would like to share on that, please write them in the comments of this video, and I will respond to you, because I'm really curious what other people think about repetition and cycles. Remember, two New Year's festivals in 1 year. That's what Gilgamesh, he wants to break the cycle, but he can't, because the cycles are eternal. Okay, so that's a good, decent introduction. Now it's on to Tablet 4, The Journey to the Forest of Cedar. I'll see you there.